Hi friends, welcome back to our section of D Decodes, where we break fragments and unveil world issues for you to know them better. In this series of the love-hate relationship of Afghanistan and Pakistan, I bring to you the second chapter, the rise of Greater Pashtunistan. The word Pashtun refers to the Iranian Pashto-speaking tribe prevalent in the areas of southern Afghanistan and northwest Pakistan. They are also called the Pakhtuns, the Pushtuns, or the Pathans. This majorly comprises Sunni population of about 40-50% of the Afghan population, near about 15 million in number, and commensurate the land that they reside on is locally called a Pashtunistan. The Pashtuns are also predominant in the Khyber Pakhtunkhwa region of Pakistan, about 31 million in strength, only to be separated by the British-created Durand Line. Pashtuns on both sides of the border share common interest much stronger than the Punjabis across the Indo-Pak international border. Their Pashtunwali code of honor emphasizes on autonomy and pay their respects to only the Jirga, a panchayat kind of system that rejects the government authorities. Thus, time and again does this demand for unification rise in the hearts of Pashtuns and their political and militant well-wishers. Recently, with the coming of a strong Taliban front and their successful hold in Afghanistan for over a year, the demand for this reunion under Greater Pashtunistan has become prevalent in popular media. But this is not the first such attempt. On attaining independence in 1947, Afghanistan had demanded a revision of the international border, but the request was denied. Mohammad Daud Khan, the Afghan president from 1973 to 1978, was a fervent Pashtun nationalist. He wanted the province of Khyber Pakhtunkhwa to be reunited with Afghanistan. His vocal demand for the same and his strong authoritarian attitude was cited as obsession by the world leaders and didn't sit well with the Pakistan regime under Ayub Khan, and trade stopped with the closing of the border. When on 23rd August 2022, there was an intense gun battle along the Paktia border on Durand Line, it seemed that it was just a matter of time before an armed Taliban moved from a concentrated area to seize territory and show light to this dream of a greater Pashtunistan. Previously in October 2021, Pakistan imposed a blockade at Chaman Post in addition to the Torkham Post to oppose Taliban's defiance in fencing the border along the Durand Line. The Greater Pashtunistan territory will include northern Pakistan, southeast Afghanistan, the Maghribi Pakhtunkhwa, Jalalabad to Kandahar, which is claimed by Pakistan, Kabul and neighboring areas which are claimed by Khorasan, and all Pakistani land on the west of River Indus is believed to fall under Pashtunistan. But what does this information of Pashtunistan mean for the Asian dynamics? Certainly, security is a major factor that the Afghan-Pak populace is concerned about. The primary strength of character of Pashtuns come from their belief that they are the closest to the Aryans. This is evident even in the Pata Khazana, or the Hidden Treasure, a manuscript of Pashtuns, which is also widely claimed as a work of forgery by its discoverer Abdul Hai Habibi. A group with such a strong head is bound to take the world in its hand. Also, if we see the past, Taliban has always been with an expansionist mindset. They have never seemed to hold fort forever and instead believe in replenishing this military strength and going ahead for more. Since it's already got a strong grip over Afghanistan, the next region under their scanner is surely the KPK. Imagine a world where the Durand Line does not exist and the Taliban and Al-Qaeda have a free pass between the Afghan-Pak region. Sounds like a recipe for disaster, doesn't it? When the Pakistan government hails support from the Taliban, they never would have predicted that the new Afghan regime would null all former Durand Line. The mistreatment of Pashtuns in Pakistan by the Pakistan government is also one to blame her. Locals all over the media have been accusing Pakistan of diverting floodwaters to KPK and safeguarding their own populace. They have been already observing 12th, 14th and 24th of August as Black Days, mourning the crimes and injustice done to them. This clubbed with the economic condition of Pakistan would just give them enough courage to break free from the shackles of an unjust Pak regime and support the Taliban aggression. Afghanistan has been involved in 26-year-long proxy war in the form of Pashtunistan with Pakistan. The lack of trust between the two nations and the non-consideration for the effects of an armed rebellion against the state is miscalculation at Pakistan's end. Even if they happily cede the Pashtun territory to the Afghan Taliban, they are just losing about 20 million tribal Pashtuns without much effect on their demography. But with the loss of KPK, Pakistan may cease to exist as a state with only the provinces of Sindh and Punjab under its so-called control. The matter remains only of time till we see a reduced Pakistan and a greater Pashtunistan. When do you think that this will come into effect? Do comment in the section below and subscribe to the Indian Affairs for more such videos.